Fire.
I command them to the abyss. Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
God of Isaac.
God of Isaac.
God of Jacob.
God of Jacob.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I adore you.
I adore you.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
The Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Counselor.
Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I worship
you. Say, wonderful Holy Ghost.
Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
I open my spirit.
I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst. And also tonight, Jesus Christ is here. The Holy Ghost is here. God Almighty is here. And we'll have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
Everybody to stand right now, everybody. We just want you to know. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Lila. Listen to this. We praise your name. We praise your name. We
Araba, Araba Yando Robosia, Araba Shia. Testimony tonight.
Amen. Amen. Our testimony reads as follows. I healed after prayer. There is a woman who called for prayer. She has been suffering from an eye problem for almost 2 years now. The left eye was painful, heavy, burning, and the burning sensation went to her brain, moving down towards the neck. She has been using antibiotics with no success. She tried using all types of pain relief, but they were just not working. The doctor was even planning to take the eye out. Pastor Robert prayed for her over the phone. The healing power of God touched her. She could feel the pain going away as the man of God prayed for her. Tears on the eye started to roll down. And she also testified that the eye is no longer heavy after prayer. She received her healing. She is healed. Glory to God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12, and then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night, and we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight we will read the Word of God from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17 from verse 23 and 19. It reads as follows. As he was talking with them, Goliath, the Philistine champion from Gath, stepped out from his lines and shouted his usual defiance, and David heard it. Whenever the Israelites saw the man, they all fled from him in great fear. Now the Israelites had been saying, "Do you see how this man keeps coming out? He comes out to defy Israel. The king will give great wealth to the man who kills him. He will also give his daughter in marriage and will exempt his family from taxes in Israel." David asked the man standing near him, "What will be done for the man who kills this Philistine and removes this disgrace from Israel? Who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?" They repeated to him what they had been saying and told him, "This is what will be done for the man who kills him." When Eliab, David's oldest brother, heard him speaking with the man, he burned with anger at him and asked, "Why have you come down here? And with whom did you leave those few sheep in the wilderness? I know how conceited you are and how wicked your heart is. You came down only to watch the battle. Now, what have I done?" said David. "Can't I even speak?" Amen.
Amen. Also tonight we will have a privilege to go through the Word of God together, believing the Word of God to be taught with power. Power of the Holy Spirit, power to heal, power to bless, power to protect in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us go through the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17. Let us read from verse number 23. The Bible says that as he was talking with them, Goliath, the Philistine champion from Gath, stepped out from his lines and shouted his usual defiance, and David heard it. The Bible is talking about there was a time that there was a battle between a Philistines and the Israelites. And the Bible said that as there was this battle, from the camp of Philistine there was a man by the name of Goliath, whom if you are describing him perfectly, he was a giant. He was not of a normal stature. And the Bible said that this Goliath of Gath, he was also a champion of the Philistines. That means if they are saying that, the word of God is telling us that he was a champion of Philistine, it means that this was the man who had fought some battles and won some battles. That's why he have got this kind of attitude. Attitude that the Bible said that Goliath will come out. And come out, when he come out, the Bible say that he will tell the army of Israel to say that, you know, in this battle, bring a man out of Israel. That man, let him face, they must face each other, and the one who wins, if he wins, Israel will be subjected to him. If Israel win, the whole of the nation of the Philistine will be subjected to him. Then he was a man who was a champion. Then the Bible said that when Goliath of Gath will come out like this, nobody will could stand before Goliath, because they could see Goliath. They could see Goliath is not an ordinary man. Goliath is a giant. When they look at him, they could look at themselves and realize it is as if this man is very big. It is as if this man is very big, is very dangerous. That's why they were scared of him. But the Bible said that one day, it was the time that David was sent by his father to go and give his brothers food in this battlefield. The Bible says that when he arrived there, as he was talking to them in verse number 23, the Bible says that Goliath, the Philistine champion from Gath, stepped out from his lines and shouted his usual defiance. And the Bible says that David heard him. And you know, it was not as if it was the first time Goliath was coming out and Goliath was speaking. The Bible said that by this time it was about 40 days. For 40 days he have been coming out. For 40 days he have been talking against Israel, talking against the God of Israel. But there was no soldier who looked at himself and thought maybe he can challenge Goliath of God. Everyone was scared of Goliath in such a way that the Bible said that the king also said that a man who will defeat Goliath, he will say that he will give his daughter for a marriage. And the Bible said that his family also will be exempted to pay tithe, to pay tax in Israel. Even though there was a treasure, there was a reward that was going to be given to a man who was going to defeat Goliath of God, there was no man who has even tried. When they look at Goliath, they saw that this man, he was a big man. This man, he was a strong man, in which physically it seems to be impossible. That's why no man has had even tried. That's why no man had even been trying, because they were looking physically to Goliath of God. They were looking physically to Goliath and of God, and thinking that Goliath of God is too big. He's too big to fight. He's too big to challenge. But the Bible says that this time he came out at the right time. This time he came out when the young man of 17 years old, who was not even a soldier, was there. Not an ordinary man, you can tell. Not an ordinary man, you can say. He's young. He's young. He's 17 years old. He's young. But this young man was anointed. Others were hearing what Goliath was saying using an ordinary ears. Physically so, and they look at Goliath, they think he's too big, and never try to challenge him because they were terrified. But David, he listened to him as a man who is filled of the Holy Ghost, who is filled of the Holy Spirit, anointed of the Holy Ghost, anointed who knows how big is his God. That's why, even though he is hearing about Goliath and he's seeing Goliath, he's not getting terrified. He's getting stirred up. He's getting stirred up because of the anointing, because of the Spirit of God. Others were hearing and they were seeing Goliath physically. When they were seeing Goliath physically, when they hear Goliath speaking, when they see his stature, they were getting terrified. Anointing. When you are anointed, when you are filled of the Holy Ghost, when you're filled of the Holy Ghost, anointed. Anointing, the Spirit of God can begin to feel through you. That's what was happening on David when he's hearing Goliath speaking. He was getting stirred up in the Spirit in such a way that even though Goliath is speaking, even though Goliath is big, David could say that, who is this uncircumcised Philistine who can talk against the armies of God, who can talk against God of Israel, and could be angry in spirit? When the Holy Spirit is in you, the Holy Spirit must be able to take over you in such a way that he feels through you, you hear through him, you see through him, and he can take over your feelings. Amen. So that you can move and act as a child of God.
Amen.
But if your flesh be more than your spirit, that's when you're gonna look at the situation, which is like a Goliath, and you get terrified. But if you are looking in any situation by the Spirit, by the enablement of the Spirit, instead of getting terrified, you can get motivated. Because you will be knowing that the bigger the problem, the bigger the testimony. the bigger the testimony, Amen. The bigger the glory.
Amen.
You know, you need a Goliath kind of a problem, because the Goliath kind of a problem is opportunity to demonstrate God's power. It's opportunity to see God's grace at work.
Amen.
You know, also it was the same thing for David. It was the time to show that he is anointed.
Amen.
Let me tell you this. Others could say there was not going to be any difference, tangible difference between the sons of Jesse. Otherwise, David was just a boy, a young man who was selected and who was anointed, and nothing happens. But it was in the day like this, it was in the day like this which we are going to see the power of that anointing.
Amen.
When you are anointed, you rejoice in problems.
Amen.
I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody. When you are anointed, you are not terrified by problems. You are motivated by problems.
Amen.
Because when you see problems, you see opportunity to demonstrate God's power.
Amen.
When you see challenges, you see the opportunity to see God's grace at work.
Amen.
Because all the times, I can tell you, child of God, all the time where you could see that David is anointed, it was in problems. It was not because everything was going well. For example, when he was called a few days ago, when you were reading about it, when he was called to go and play and worship for Saul, he was worshiping for Saul because Saul was being demon attacked. And when he was demon attacked, nobody could calm Saul down. Nobody could deal with that problem. I'm sure they've tried. And that's why now they are saying, no, there is a young man who is anointed. God is with him.
Amen.
And when God is with him, when he worships, his glory comes down. When he praises, as the praising is going up, his glory comes down. The anointing, the presence of God can deal with what you are dealing with, Saul. And again today, David is about, we are about, everybody is about to know that David is anointed.
Amen.
Before that, nobody could know that David is anointed, but today they were about to find out that indeed the Spirit of the living God is upon him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Child of God, the Spirit of God is coming, have come upon you. You have been anointed. When you are anointed, is to deal with difficult problems.
Amen.
Is to deal with difficult challenges.
Amen.
So that at the end of the day, you can speak like Apostle Paul and say that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Amen.
I can do all things through Christ who energizes me.
Amen.
We are anointed also to deal with difficult problems.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says that in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse number 24, whenever the Israel saw the man, they fled from him in great fear. They could see this big man, this big giant physically. They could see this big giant. That's why when they look at him, the Bible said that the soldiers were running away with great fear. But the Bible said that young man David, he was not terrified by the how big Goliath is.
Amen.
The young man David, he was motivated to say that he was stirred up in spirit and said that nobody can talk against God of Israel like this.
Amen.
I'm here. I'm the child of God. That must be your attitude when you see any problem that is ridiculing your God. Where you are saying that, no, this cannot trouble the children of God when I'm here. I am anointed for this.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Child of God, you are anointed. We need to be motivated by problems.
Amen.
We need to be motivated by challenges.
Amen.
Because it is in the midst of problem that you will know how big is your God.
Amen.
How glorious is your God.
Amen.
And the Bible says that now the Israelites were saying, do you see how this man keeps coming out? He comes out to defy the Israel. The king will give a great wealth to the man who kills this man. He will also give him his daughter in marriage. And will exempt his family from taxes. From taxes in Israel. Then the Bible says that in verse number 26. Of 1 Samuel chapter 17. David asked men standing near him, what will be done for the man who kills the Philistines and remove the disgrace from Israel? Who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of God? I don't know whether you are getting this.
Amen.
You know, Amen. The one who's speaking here is David, a young man who is not even there to fight. A young man who's not even there to fight, who was there to give his brothers food. But now God is speaking through him.
Amen.
He does not see how big is the problem.
Amen.
He can see how big is Jehovah.
Amen.
Every time in our life, Amen. May the Spirit of God stir us to see how big is our God in every circumstances, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because Amen. Many people are being defeated by challenges and problems.
Amen.
Because instead of seeing how big is their God, they see how big is the problem. And the enemy convinced them that the problem is bigger than God. That's the why certain problems, certain challenges cannot be solved. Because people, the enemy have made some people to be defeated in their minds.
Amen.
In their faith. So that they don't believe that God can do this. I want you to get this, child of God. The Bible says that all things are possible to do what? To them that believe.
Amen.
If you can believe it, God can do it.
Amen.
If you can believe it, God can do what? God can do it. But if you can't believe it, God cannot do it. God can do in accordance to your faith.
Amen.
If you can believe in the Bible, all things are possible to them that believe.
Amen.
Most of Amen. The time what the enemy does is to make sure that you believe that the problem is bigger than your God. Once you believe that the problem at hand is bigger than your God, you are finished. I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody.
Amen.
Want to believe Amen. That the problem is bigger than what God can do. You are finished.
Amen.
Then child of God, You must always know that greater is he that's within us than he that is in the world. There is no bigger problem than our God. There is no situation that God cannot change.
Amen.
There is no problem that
Amen.
God cannot solve.
Amen.
There is no sickness that God cannot heal.
Amen.
There is no blessing that
Amen.
God cannot give.
Amen.
Our God is bigger Amen. Than any problem.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
Say fire, yeah, 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 yeah. I love the word of God. I'm enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the book of Psalm 118, verse number 6, the Bible say that the Lord is with me. I will not be afraid. Hey, what can a mere mortal do to me? The Bible says that, hey, the Lord is with me. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
The greater than the greatest is with me.
Amen.
That must be your attitude. That God is with me.
Amen.
Mightier than the mightiest is with me.
Amen.
Stronger than the strongest is with me.
Amen.
The creator of heaven and earth is what? Is with me.
Amen.
And after that you go like, I will not be afraid.
Amen.
No, that was the attitude of David before Goliath. David was like, hey, greater than the greatest is with me.
Amen.
Mightier than the mightiest is with me.
Amen.
And he was like, Goliath, it is as if you are big physically. Goliath, it is as if you are big physically. But you are not bigger than my God. My God is bigger than you. That's why he's saying that, what can a mere mortal do to me?
Amen.
I want you to look at that problem. I want you to look at that person and you say that, hey, the Lord is with me.
Amen.
Look at that sickness and say that the Lord is with me.
Amen.
Greater than the greatest is with me. Can you say ha 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 ha?
Say
mightier than the mightiest is with me.
Mightier than the mightiest is with me.
Ocean divider is with me.
Ocean divider is with me.
Say you problem, you are too small.
You problem, you are too small.
You sickness, you are too small. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
Let me tell you this. Goliath was going to be a giant if you are looking to God. Goliath as a human being.
Amen.
But right now, because God is by your side, you are not looking at Goliath as a man.
Amen.
You are the child of the living God. And God is what is with you.
Amen.
God is what is
Amen.
With us.
Amen.
Miracle worker is with us.
Amen.
Ocean divider is with us.
Amen.
And the Bible Amen. Said that because of that, I will not be afraid.
Amen.
David to him was like, Goliath, you are what? You are nothing.
Amen.
Can you say, you my Goliath?
You are nothing.
You are nothing. I'm not afraid of you.
I am not afraid of you.
I'm not afraid of you.
I can't be afraid of you.
I'm the child of the living God.
Ocean divider is with me.
God of signs and wonders is with me.
God
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody tonight. I'm saying that he will make a way where there seems to be no way. He will perform a miracle and give you a solution in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As long as you see and you know that the greater than the greatest is by your side.
Amen.
Ocean divider is by your side.
Amen.
The problem is that you are forgetting that you are the child of God.
Amen.
That was the problem of these soldiers. That's why they are looking to Goliath man to man. Child of God, we are not in the same level.
Amen.
Can you say, you my Goliath?
You my Goliath.
You are, we are not in the same level.
We are not in the same level.
I'm the child of the living God.
I am the child of the living God.
Most of the problem starts when you forget that you are the child of God. The enemy wants to isolate you from God. He wants to get you at the corner. That's the biggest problem. The enemy wants to get you at the corner. He knows that if he gets you at the corner, man to man, Goliath will be a giant.
Amen.
But if you come with your God, Goliath is nobody.
Amen.
That problem is nothing. That sickness is nothing.
Amen.
That situation is nothing.
Amen.
Because you have got the one whom the Bible said with God all things are what are possible. He can do anything, anytime, and anywhere.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Always remember, always know that you have got the one whom the Bible said that all things will always work together for good to them that love God.
Amen.
Because you will make sure that in every circumstances and every situation you come out victorious.
Amen.
You come out successful.
Amen.
That's why you must say that the Lord is with me. Hey, the Lord is with me, and I will not be afraid.
Amen.
And you say, what can a mere Goliath do to me?
Amen.
I'm the child of the Almighty God.
Amen.
See that situation from God's perspective.
Amen.
See that Goliath in God's perspective. You will realize this is just a man. He'll just look big. But he's not bigger than my God. It is time to show Goliath and the whole nation that we serve a living God.
Amen.
I want you to talk to that problem tonight and say that you problem, you Goliath, you challenge, you are about to see the power of God. Can you say that? Can you tell that problem? Say, you problem.
You problem.
You Goliath.
You Goliath.
You will see the power of God.
You will see the power of God.
You will see that I serve the living God.
You will see that I serve the living God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
Jesus.
Goliath is used to deal with me, amen. That's why he's a champion.
Amen.
He's not a champion when he's fighting God.
Amen.
I'm the child of God.
Amen.
God give birth to God.
Amen.
Today, Goliath, that man, that challenge is facing God.
Amen.
And he's not aware and he's about to find out.
Amen.
When the Bible said that God arise and his enemies will be scattered. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Our God is arising and our enemy and his enemies is going to be scattered.
Amen.
There will be a way where there seems to be no way.
Amen.
things will turn around for your good.
Amen.
You will be the last one to laugh.
Amen.
You will be the last one to celebrate.
Amen.
You will be the last one to sing the song of joy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I speak over your circumstance. I say you will testify.
Amen.
I don't know who I'm talking to, but I'm talking to somebody tonight.
Amen.
I'm saying to you, you are about to see the power of God.
Amen.
We are about to see the power of God.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody. Don't be afraid, child of God.
Amen.
The bigger the problem, the bigger the testimony.
Amen.
The bigger the testimony, the bigger the glory.
Amen.
Then you are about to come back with a big testimony.
Amen.
I'm talking to you tonight.
Amen.
You are about to come back with a bigger testimony.
Amen.
Where the whole world will know about our great God.
Amen.
The whole world will know about our mighty God.
Amen.
Where at the end of the day, they will say that there is a God of David.
Amen.
God of Lazarus.
Amen.
God who answers and changes circumstances.
Amen.
We refuse to fear. We refuse to bow down to any Goliath. Right now you are about to prepare to go and pray. Oh, Rabayan Toloboshia Karabababa. Hey, Katabaika. Manda Gida Gadabagiros. As America Kerebabababa. Yanda Rabayika Toloboboboba. La caraba shekerebaba, caraba y cotona baya, mandaraba y el cholo cotorobo, alba carito como cataraba, shandiaba, shandiaba, mandaraba y andaraba y ga, mandaraba y el deleba, alba cachandaraba sondolobo. I command them to the abyss. Anything which is not of God in my life, in my family, in my career, in every sector of my life, catch fire now, catch fire now, catch fire now. I command them. Come out. 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 I command them to the abyss. Say, I command everything to turn around for my good. Everything. Turn around for my goal. So let there be progress. 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 In every sector of our lives. So let there be miracle jobs. Miracle jobs. Miracle jobs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Lord Jesus Christ, you are my Lord, you are my Savior, wash me with your blood, forgive me my sins, bless me today, protect me from today, from today. I am born again. I am saved. Say, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Surely goodness and love shall follow me all the days of my life, and I dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In the name of Jesus. Wherever you are, receive every blessing that you want. Receive every job that you want, every answer that you want from the presence of God, from the glory of the Lord. Receive every solution that you are looking for in the name of Jesus Christ. Every answer that you want, receive it. Receive it from the presence of God. Receive it from the glory of God. And send the fire of the Holy Spirit wherever you want a miracle. Wherever you want the miracle, I send the fire in our houses, in our cars, in our working places, in our everything. We send the fire of the Holy Ghost. And we send that anointing to talk for us, to turn everything for our good in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And I want to say to us tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye-bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon, and night.
Amen. Bye-bye.
Bye.